Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata for protection against COVID-19. Please all kneel. Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, health of the sick,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
San Roque,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us. Good morning, brothers and sisters. Please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his grace. We, the daughters and sons of him, who built the valleys and plains, praise the wonders our God has done in every heart that sings. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Blessings he bears to those who trust in his grace.
We are now gathered together. Let us begin our holy celebration. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, in our readings today, we will encounter how Jesus Christ really concerns for our life. In order for us to become worthy of the holy celebration, let us pause for a while, and in silence, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Amaziah, the priest of Bethel, sent word to Jeroboam, king of Israel. Amos has conspired against you here within Israel. The country cannot endure all his words. For this is what Amos says: Jeroboam shall die by the sword, and Israel shall surely be exiled from its land. To Amos, Amaziah said, Off with you, visionary, flee to the land of Judah. There, earn your bread by prophesying, but never again prophesy in Bethel, for it is king's sanctuary and a royal temple. Amos answered Amaziah, I was no prophet, nor have I belonged to a company of prophets. I was a shepherd and a dresser of sycamores. The Lord took me from following the flock and said to me, Go, prophesy to my people Israel. Now hear the word of the Lord. You say, Prophesy not against Israel, preach not against the house of Isaac. Now thus says the Lord, Your wife shall be made a harlot in the city, and your sons and daughters shall fall by the sword. Your land shall be divided by measuring line, and you yourself shall die in an unclean land. Israel shall be exiled far from its land. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just.
The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just.
The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The decree of the Lord is trustworthy, giving wisdom to the simple.
The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just.
The precepts of the Lord are right and rejoicing the heart. The command of the Lord is clear, enlightening the eye.
The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just.
The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The ordinances of the Lord are true, all of them just.
The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just.
They are more precious than gold, than a heap of purest gold, sweeter also than syrup or honey from the comb.
The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just. Please stand.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ and entrusting to us the message of reconciliation.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After entering a boat, Jesus made the crossing and came into his own town. And there people brought to him a paralytic lying on a stretcher. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Courage, child, your sins are forgiven." At that, some of the scribes said to themselves, "This man is blaspheming." Jesus knew that they were thinking and said, "Why do you harbor evil thoughts? Which is easier to say, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Rise and walk'? But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins." He then said to the paralytic, "Rise, pick up your stretcher, and go home." He rose and went home. When the crowds saw this, they were struck with awe and glorified God who had given such authority to men. Sisters and brothers, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Nasubukan niyo na ba na magpakonsulta sa isang doktor at binawalan kayo ng mga pagkaing paborito ninyo? Have you ever had an experience of consulting a doctor and then you were advised to forbid about some food which really pleasing to you? I had my a series of schedules in Bulacan last December. Dahil iyon ay malapit na ang Pasko, I was able to talk to a friend who shared to me his experience of consulting a doctor in preparation for Christmas celebration. Kasi sabi niya, malapit na po ang Pasko, Father, kaya kailangan kong magpa-check up. And then what was told to you by the doctor, I asked him. Oh, the doctor told me not to eat too much food which I really like. Eh, anong gagawin mo ngayon? Sabi ko, may gamot naman, Father. And sometimes that experience is also our own experience, that even though we are advised not to eat too much food which are forbidden for us, we still crave for those because we think there are medicines to cure our illness. And I mention this, my dear brothers and sisters, because in the gospel today, we saw and heard that Jesus is concerned to heal the paralytic not only of his physical illness, not only of his paralysis, but also his spiritual healing. We do not know the situation of this paralytic, but we already know that he was brought to Jesus by his friends, and perhaps it was because of their concern for him. At minsan nga iisipin natin ano, yun bang tao na dinala kay Jesus, talaga bang yung kanyang paralysis ang gusto niyang gumaling? Or maybe he had something else. Sometimes it is easier to see the physical illness rather than our own spiritual illness. At madali rin sa atin, kapag tayo nagdarasal sa Panginoon, we ask for favors to give us temporal blessings. Sabihin natin magandang trabaho, good health, good relationship. And sometimes we tend to forget our own spiritual failures, which we sometimes overlook of asking forgiveness. Dahil hindi natin madaling nakikita kung ano yung mga pagkukulang natin, kaya hindi madalas na ipinagdarasal natin yung spiritual na pangangailangan natin. And perhaps also, that was the reason why the scribes commented on what Jesus said to the paralytic. Your sins are forgiven. Yan ang sinabi ni Jesus sa taong may paralitiko. But the scribes said, he is blaspheming because to forgive sins is only for God. Perhaps their blindness is not only for looking Jesus as God already, but they also did not see yet that the paralytic had something else to ask for healing. At kung minsan sa buhay natin, ito yung nagiging dahilan kung bakit nagiging mas mabigat yung karanasan natin. Sometimes, our illness does not need cure but healing. And they are two different things. Cure is for something that is physical or external, but healing is something internal. And so we understand now why there are people who are still on bed, but they are peaceful. Some would say, I'm still blessed even though I have sickness because my friends love me, because my parents take care of me, because my loved ones are always with me. And so if we are going to apply this in our life, my dear brothers and sisters, we are also asked to follow Jesus in the same way that he gives healing to each one of us. Sometimes we only pray for the physical healing of our relatives, of our friends, of our loved ones. But we also need to ask God for their spiritual healing. We do not see spiritual healing, but we often see physical illness. But Jesus, He sees them both. Both physical and spiritual illness. He sees them both. That is why we should understand that Jesus fosters life in every situation. And that is also for that reason, He always gives us His healing holistically. My dear brothers and sisters, we ask the Lord to give us courage to acknowledge our own weakness, our own failures, because sometimes our physical illness becomes severe because we are not peaceful. Sometimes what we need is spiritual healing that makes us humble and admit that God should grant us forgiveness.
Please stand.
With all the trust of the paralytic's friends, let us bring to the Lord the needs and miseries of the church and the world. In every petition, we say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church of God may be constantly at work in carrying out Christ's saving mission through forgiveness of sins. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That priests who celebrate the sacrament of reconciliation may always show compassion and understanding to penitents. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may always be ready to forgive others, realizing that this is the shared duty of all who follow Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and the handicapped may find comfort and hope in their sufferings. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all those who have died may share in Christ's eternal peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for the forgiveness shown to us by your Son. May we in turn show forgiveness to all who have offended us. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who graciously accomplish the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him you have been pleased to renew all things, giving us all a share in his fullness. For though he was in the form of God, he emptied himself, and by the blood of his cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore he has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey him has become the source of eternal salvation. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
This is Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart.
I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
My soul finds rest in God alone. My salvation comes from Him. He alone is my rock, my salvation, my fortress. I shall never be afraid. I shall never be afraid.
Please stand.
Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
At palang nilikha, ipinaglihikwan ang sana. Pusong dalis ay nakilang Maria, ina ng Ama.
Thank you.